Rod Serling. You're listening to The Zero Hour. Rest your eyes. Exercise your imagination. Today, Keith Walker's double tale of terror in space. Skylab, are you there? Starring William Shatner. In a Mutual Broadcasting System presentation of The Zero Hour.
Brought to you by the Ford Motor Company, Shenley Industries, Matus Wine, Beechnut Chewing Tobacco, and Dial Soap. This is The Zero Hour on Mutual Radio.
This planet lurk many mysteries of the universe not yet revealed to us. But consider this. Perhaps they have been, but there is a decree from some higher authority that will not allow us to be told. What then?
How are you coming, John?
North Pole, they're tricky. Number 4 still won't extend. Wait, I thought I felt something move.
Anything?
No, for a minute there. I'll keep working. Skylab, this is Houston. Do you copy?
Go ahead, Houston.
What is your status on the panel? Panel 2 and 3 now fully extended and operational. The arm on 4 panel is still askew in its channel.
Roger, Skylab. Let us know if we should recompute any of your program.
Wait, it's shifting.
John, what's wrong?
Telemetry on panel F's vital signs fluctuating erratically.
John, can you hear me? John! Pat, suit up. I'm going out.
Right.
Houston, are you copying?
Roger, Skylab.
Colonel Ebb is not responding. Maybe injured. Dr. Kent and I are suiting up now. We will depressurize, and I will attempt to bring Ebb back in.
Roger, Skylab. Dick Conroy is on his way to the floor. He'll be taking over.
Pat, switch on your suit transmitter.
Can we both go out?
No, you stay here and set up your surgery.
Skylab, this is Houston.
Dick Conroy, are you copying?
Roger, Dick. We are now depressurizing labs. That's your meat tonight. Right, moving ahead.
Jack, Ebb's signs are weakening.
Roger, Houston. Stand by.
Houston, I'm heading up the mobile video scan server side.
We will monitor. Skylab, we are showing attitude change on the station. Can you advise?
Hold on. Move deck.
Houston, can you read the patch?
5 by 5, Jack.
I am drifting toward the capsule.
Houston, I can confirm. We're rotating laterally and kick off again. Also, slight horizontal rotate, but erratic.
Houston, it's possible that when the panel pops, its torque caused the station to spin.
That must be corrected immediately. Angle rotation will cause orbit decay.
Can you give me time brackets on delay correction?
Austin, set it up on the computer.
Roger. I can see him. The colonel took it up to the extreme of his lifeline. John, can you hear me?
Pat, that's good on the camera. We're following visually.
A movement from Ebb. Almost there.
Vital signs very erratic.
I got him. Bring him in now.
Roger. Pat, can you take decay corrections?
I'm standing by surgery. Can you institute corrections from your station?
Roger, set up on the board computer through Orient Circuit. We will feed.
Pat, coming in. Give me a hand. Inside. I'm going to say...
Transmitter, are you copying?
We are copying.
Jack, look at his chest.
Let's get his suit off. Houston, Colonel Ebb's on the table. Pat is examining him now. I am checking capsule.
Standing by, Scott.
Houston, Ebb has a massive chest convection. Possibly 6 ribs shattered. 2 feet as if they may have shifted into the heart wall.
Skylab, you will have to abort the mission.
Roger, Houston, I'm working on that now.
Pat, what are chances we bring him down?
Better than if he stays here. The sooner the doctor...
Hold it, Pat. Houston, we have a problem. We cannot abort. I repeat, we cannot abort. Return capsule will not take pressurization, and number 2 fuel tank punctured.
Are you sure, Jack?
Positive, Houston. Fragments of the solar panel must have punctured capsule. We cannot return to Earth.
Dick, here are the figures for the chute.
Good.
Dick, you're going to wipe yourself out.
Can the sympathy.
I'm sorry,
you're right.
These show the Saturn on pad 9 will be operational in 11 hours.
How about Eckert?
He's lucky. He just finished simulation. He'll be ready when we are.
Well, let's give the good news to Skylab. Potter, activate the link.
Hi, Mr. Conroe. This is Julie Azor.
Thanks. Skylab, this is Houston.
We are copying, Houston.
Is Jack monitoring?
Yes, sir. He's in the capsule, but Pat.
We can mount a Saturn for rescue. We go to countdown in 30 minutes. Major Kenyon Eckert will be a command pilot. We are programmed for an 11-hour count, and if we get lucky... Wait a minute, strike that. We are lucky. We can rendezvous at 20 hours, 30 minutes.
Houston, we don't have much time. Colonel Ed is critical, barely holding his own, still unconscious. Heart is getting very erratic readings.
We're all praying. Jack, do you copy?
Wait, Houston, no luck here. The capsule's worse than I thought. Even if I could get up pressure...
Houston, stand by. Colonel Ed's heart is stopped. I'm attempting a dual and a heart rate.
Skylab, your transmission has been interrupted. Say again. Skylab, do you copy? This is Houston, Skylab. Are you there?
Dick, I'm getting telemetry on the lab, but...
But what?
You're not going to believe this. There is no telemetry on life signs.
That can't be.
See for yourself.
That's crazy. According to this, there's no one on the station.
Dick, they're locking down the hatch now.
All right. Let me know when Eckert comes up. And keep the press out. Have PR tell them we'll do a conference once Eckert's on his way.
Eckert.
Right. Major Eckert, Conroy, how do you feel?
Perfect.
So do you. We are T-minus 30 and counting.
Roger, I'm ready to fly this bird.
So are we.
Anything new on the station?
No, and we're not telling the press anything except we've got a communication problem. Remember that when you get on the command circuit.
Got it. That's hard to figure.
Got to be a simple explanation. But we know they're there. I know it.
Yeah. Where else can they be?
30 seconds and counting.
Second stage tanks now pressurized.
25 seconds.
Power transfer complete.
20 seconds and counting.
All systems go.
Guidance is now internal.
15 seconds.
Green. All systems green.
10. 9. Ignition sequence starts.
All systems go.
Looking good. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
All engines firing.
Beautiful. T plus 10.
Now at 60,000, all reading green.
Coming up on second stage.
All readings still go for second stage.
Second stage firing, 10 seconds.
All right.
All right. Take your seats. Calm down. I've got a prepared statement. Ladies and gentlemen, you'll have to take this as it is. I've got no time for questions. Here's the status. Major Eckert is approximately 1 hour from docking with Skylab. He'll transfer Colonel Ebb to the capsule and bring him back to Earth.
Well, yeah, but...
Now, hold it. Will you hold it, please? There's no reason to believe they're not up there. I know what's on your mind, but let me assure you, in all probability, there's been simply a communication failure. And that's all it is. Eckert's job is simply to return Colonel Ebb. That will give us a breather and time to figure out how to make the necessary repairs in the capsule. That's it.
Houston,
I now have a matching orbit with Skylab.
Roger, rescue. What's it look like?
Like a tomb. No sign of life through the ports. I'm now depressurizing a capsule. I'll walk across to the station. I'm now leaving capsule. I will secure a line to the station from the capsule.
Roger.
If you'll forgive the analogy, tying up like this makes me think of the horse and buggy.
Modern ingenuity, Major.
Approaching station hatch.
Austin, any change in telemetry?
Nothing, Dick. The suspense is killing me.
Yeah.
Houston, I'm inside the station. Houston, There's no one here.
Rescue, this is Houston.
Go ahead, Houston.
You are to prepare for return. We're reprogramming for re-entry, and we'll feed the data shortly. We have several assignments for you to accomplish before then.
I am copying.
Set up the cabin for video scan. We're going to fine-tooth comb on video for examination. Also have the infrared adapter ready, then pull all film from the analyzers and transfer to your vehicle.
Roger. Video scan is now operating. Take it anytime.
Switching now. Major Eckert, are you sure you switched the scan to inboard relay?
Roger, Houston. I show power on the equipment.
Okay, stand by one. Dick, can you come here?
What do you got?
A carrier wave, but no picture. It's almost as if there's some strong energy source blocking transmission.
Slide over. I'll use your board. Eckert, check your gamma analyzer now.
Aye, aye. Doing it now.
Real.
Hey, that's high, Conroy. About 5/12 interior.
Okay, stand by.
What do you think you've got?
Just a hunch. Crazy. Probably nothing. Eckert, I want you to set up the infrascanner for interior.
Can do. Give me a minute.
Right, and when you've got it set, patch it through the board and scanner circuits. Austin, switch the feed to the board scope.
Working.
Relay now.
What was that?
Houston, what are you getting at? No monitor.
Eckert, now listen carefully. I want you to pan the scanner left to right and freeze when I say.
Panning.
I've never seen anything like it. Freeze scan.
Impossible. How?
Houston, what have you got?
Major, we are looking at our Skylab team, plus there is one human form with them.
You mean they're up here with me?
The way it looks, the infra images are very hazy, but I'm sure it's Pat Kent, Jack Elton, and Colonel Ebb. The other form is gesturing and pointing towards the scanner.
Oh.
We've lost the scan. Austin, are you all right?
Yeah. Just lots of spots before my eyes.
Rescue, this is Houston. We're getting no visual on infra. Switch back.
Houston, this is Colonel
Ebb. John? John? Is that you?
Very much so, Dick. Alive and well.
How? Pat said your heart stopped.
Dick, I must request that we discontinue conversation. Would you please go to scramble on the priority circuit?
Roger. Switching now.
Scott, I'll be read.
Roger, Houston. Dick, we've been requested to keep the following information secret, at least for a time. Pat will fill you in on the beginning sequences.
Houston, what has happened is truly without medical precedent. Colonel Ebb was brought back to life. Mr. Conroy, we have been watched.
Watched? What do you mean?
At the moment, the Colonel's heart stopped. There was a blinding light shift in the lab. It was accompanied by a physical wrenching, almost as if our lives had shifted in time, which in fact it did. A man, no, better called a humanoid, was suddenly in the lab with us. He, she, told us it had been ordered to return Colonel Ebb to life.
I'll take it, Pat. Houston, the alien's name was Hobb. It left a message for us to play as explanation. Jack is integrating it into your circuits. Are you receiving visual?
Yes. What is that thing?
They call it a communicube.
A tape recorder?
In a way. As they explain it, the cube projects audio and visual into any receiver, electronic or the mind. Stand by.
Hobb is my designator. I am a special monitor assigned to your planet. For the past 600 years, it has been my duty to observe and report your progress toward space exploration. I represent, in your reference term, the Council of Worlds, a higher order civilization of 2,000 world planets. The Council is responsible for admitting new worlds into the Federation when they have attained a proper civilized level. Your planet has not yet attained that status. As the observer, I am gifted with the ability to read alternate futures. When the death of Colonel Ebb occurred, it changed the future course of Earth's progress. This could not be allowed, and thus the Council gave permission for re-life. To explain, Colonel Ebb will be the dominating personality responsible for your reaching the civilized status for membership. He will also be needed for future contact and space exploration. You are advised, under maximum penalty, to hold this information in absolute secret. Under no circumstance is this to be broadcast to the people of Earth at this time. This is Hobb. We will be waiting.
John, is that all?
Yes. The cube has disappeared.
Nick, Hobb's words did not recall. How do we have to tell Noah?
The Council's instructions were very specific. Only that Skylab had a problem with its solar panels and power. That is all.
Under penalties. I hate to think what they might be. Prepare for return to Earth, Skylab.
Roger, Houston. We hear you.
I'm Rod Serling. Close your eyes. Exercise your imagination. And join us again on our next presentation of The Zero Hour.
Skylab, Are You There? Is an original radio drama written by Keith Walker. William Shatner was heard as Richard Conroy. Featured in the cast were Jacques Denbrough, Kathleen Cordell, Casey Kasem, Les Tremaine, and Jack Cushman. Zero Hour, created by J.M. Polis, directed by Don Hills, is produced in Hollywood for the Mutual Broadcasting System by Radio Productions Incorporated. Music is composed and conducted by Stanley B. Hoffman. Michelle Sherman, associate producer. This has been a presentation of the Mutual Broadcasting System.